It's the most wonderful time of the year. No, it's not December. It is April, National Poetry Month. It is the month designated to promote poetry, not only to further understand its importance, but to make us more aware of how the art form is woven into our everyday life and to celebrate its awesomeness. From literature to live readings to write-in to slang to cliches, etc. And today, we're going to explain its origins, how it's celebrated, and some cool footnotes you may or may not be aware of. National Poetry Month, you are about to get defined. The Academy of American Poets had this great idea bouncing around in their head for a while. So in 1995, they reached out to publishers, booksellers, librarians, literary organizations, poets, friends, and more to discuss it. They spoke about what Black History and Women's History Month accomplished and wondered if poetry could find success in a similar fashion. Apparently they believe so, because when the clock struck April 1996, National Poetry Month was born. The celebration truly began to pick up momentum come 1998. The Academy of American Poets and the American Poetry and Literacy Project distributed 100,000 free books nationwide. The White House also began to invite poets to share their work as part of the celebration. Pretty straightforward and simple. Already we know the who, what, where, when, and why. So the major question now is, how? How is National Poetry Month celebrated? There really is no right or wrong way. The basic purpose is to bring about awareness and inspire some enthusiasm. But here are some popular methods and ways you can participate. Number 1, the 30-30, probably the most popular. Everyone is challenged to write one new poem per day, 30 poems in 30 days, hence its name, the 30-30. 2, each year there is a day in April designated as Poem in Your Pocket Day. Everyone is encouraged to carry around their favorite poem in their pocket and to share it with others. This tends to be huge in schools and libraries, which may hold open mic events for students to come up and read their selected poem. 3. The Academy of American Poets offers free posters to bring awareness to the celebration. If you work at a place frequented by students or connoisseurs of the arts, you should definitely order one. The link to request a free poster is in the description of this video. 4. Read a new poem each day during April, something you've never read before. I suggest you do so in the morning and think about the poem for the whole day. Discuss its concept and the emotion behind it with others. Not all poems are deep or dark. I know some limericks which are hilarious and a little dirty. Whichever type of poems you choose is up to you. Just be sure to get into the spirit of giving. Number 5. My favorite. And it's not popular yet, but I'm hoping it will be one day. Share Poetry Defined. Yup, total shameless self-promotion right here. But in truth, that is part of the point of this month, to support poetry and poets. In April, many publishers and literature merchants give discounts on books of poetry. A lot of promotional material floods the market as well. So even if you're not interested in sharing Poetry Defined, but why wouldn't you? You should definitely make the effort to promote organizations and websites you enjoy which showcase and discuss poetry. Before we close out this video, I need to mention those who despise this month. And I don't mean individuals who dislike poetry. No, I mean poets who hate this month. The general consensus of those who dislike it believe it trivializes poetry. It needlessly oversaturates the readership for 4 weeks, and it is not significantly increasing the population of poetry lovers. These individuals believe poetry is an inescapable everyday thing, and giving it a month is a backhanded compliment. I don't necessarily agree or disagree with their gripe, but I will say this. Poetry has been, and always will be, surrounding us every day. If you're only into poetry come April, you are completely cheating yourself. Okay, I have a few more quick footnotes to share. The first or second Thursday of October, because it changes from year to year, is National Poetry Day in the UK. Unlike celebrations in the United States, the United Kingdom gives a specific theme to celebrate. This day is very much like America's Poem in Your Pocket Day. 3 years after the celebration began in the US, Canada followed suit. April is their National Poetry Month as well. But each year they choose a specific theme to follow in similar fashion to how the United Kingdom does. Last but not least, March 21st is World Poetry Day. All around the globe, the world celebrates poetry. This was declared by UNESCO. to give fresh recognition and impetus to national, regional, and international poetry movements. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. And as always, spread the cheer. Share this with friends and loved ones. And if you're feeling extra special, share it with your enemies too. So, give that subscribe and like button a click. Thanks, and stay tuned for more Poetry Defined. And you're in luck. We have two definitions for you. One, in a broader sense of the definition, poetry is the creation of imagination. Paragraphs and follow the laws of grammar. Your everyday speech, novels, essays, news articles, the law, etc. are all prose.